What is up, everyone? My name is Cody, and I've got another commentary here for you guys today. This is Hardpoint on the map Yemen. This is not a very strong map. We haven't been playing very well on it lately, so we've been trying to scrim whenever we get the chance. This is actually a league play match. It is my team Above Reality versus the number one team in Masters, which is TVA. I don't do very well this game. I'm going to go out here and go ahead and say that. But we, we pulled together and we won as a team. So, I thought that it was a nice gameplay. And, if we beat the number one team in Masters, I think that's a pretty decent feat. I know that, they're obviously not the best team. But, obviously they play a lot if they're going to be the number one team in League. So, that's pretty cool that we were able to pull off the win here. It was a pretty tight game for most of the way. So, overall, I feel like I shouldn't really be needing to explain my gameplay as much, but it was a good win overall, so I hope that you guys enjoy that. I probably won't be talking about it that much more. Just go into more of my competitive side here of Black Ops 2. Let you guys know what's been going on. I know I haven't done any commentaries here on Black Ops 2, but, I've just been kind of uploading some clips, stuff like that. So if you guys didn't know, like I said, I've been playing Black Ops 2 competitively. It's been picked up by the circuit. If you guys weren't following that, then that's pretty awesome. Call of Duty's gonna be on the circuit this year. I'm gonna be having some events throughout the year. First one's gonna be Dallas, and then Anaheim. I'm gonna be trying to head up to Anaheim. Not really sure if I'm gonna have the funds at the time, but I'm gonna start saving now. So hopefully I'll be ready there. Whenever that comes around. But my current team is myself, Cruzin, who's also known as Dare Cruz. If any of you guys watched him back when he did trick shotting, that would be him. If not, then he's known as Cruzin. And also, I'm not even sure how many people I just named. Myself, Cruzin. Yeah, I remember. Okay, just those two. Dami C, who is Cruzin's brother, and Chabong. And I'm sure you guys have seen Chabong from other videos. Me and him have been playing together for a couple years now, nonstop. So it's kind of cool, to. To keep teaming with him. If you guys didn't know, Cruzin and Dami C, yeah, like I said, they're brothers, so I know both of them in real life. I go to school with Cruzin, we all kind of hang out. It's kind of cool that we were able to get a team together with people that are all local. Hopefully we can stick together and, just keep playing together if we keep up how we've been doing. We actually went to the Gamers Forgiving, or the Gamers Outreach, LAN this past Saturday, which was, as of now, it was 2 days ago, so, I still got a little bit of a fresh memory, but, we did well. It was, Cruzin and Dom's first LAN, the first LAN that me and Chabong went to together. We lost first two maps that we played, so that was kind of embarrassing. We were the kids that we thought we were gonna be good going into it, it's really not an excuse, but the LAN was the NJ Halo was very poorly run, so it was just basically a bad experience overall. Very poorly run, and we lost first round. It just wasn't a fun place to be that weekend. Coming back into it, we went into this Gamers Forgiving LAN. We were ready to be knocked out first round if that's what it was going to be, because it's happened to us before. So we were open to that possibility because we all got with different schedules. We're not able to practice. Dom's got a full-time job. He's, once people are grown up, you got to be out there in that working field. So, we're only able to play after like 11 o'clock with him. So, not much practice going into it. We were ready to take whatever we were given. But remarkably, we won our first three rounds, which put us, playing in the semifinals, which is pretty cool. And actually, in those first three rounds, we won 2-0 in every one of them. So we had not dropped a map until we went into semifinals. And there we played Elite Pro, or Elite. I'm not really sure which they prefer to be called. They're Elite Pro on the bracket. So we played up against Elite Pro, which was, I'm going to completely destroy their names, but I know Wolf was one of them, and they played with Dream Crazy. Those are just the two names that I remember off the top of my head. They actually went up to win it. They won the $1,500, so 1.5K, one big ones and that big check. They ended up winning it all. So, us losing to them semifinals and then getting knocked into loser's bracket, I guess, was just, you know, bad placement, bad luck for us. You know, wrong part of the bracket at the wrong part of time. But, you know, we got knocked into the loser's bracket. And by then, it was about 11 o'clock. Honestly, we were just a little worn out. And lost the second map in a row, or lost our second round in a row after the loser's bracket. So we finished up fifth. Personally, you know, no offense to anybody that placed higher than us, but I personally feel like we were the second best team there. So, you know, just knowing that and just playing against people that I that have played online and have been destroyed by online, and just playing against them in LAN and, you know, just coming up on top is a pretty good feeling. You know, just an example, I'm really not trying to throw anybody under the bus, but a team plays higher than us that, you know, we beat 2-0, so. You know, it's just kind of shitty that we had to wait 3 hours in between rounds, and, you know, by the time we finally played our losers round match, it was 11 o'clock at night, you know, maybe even close to 12. I know that they didn't finish the finals until about 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock in the morning, so, you know, it was a little bit disorganized in the sense of time, but other than that, it was a very well-run event. You know, if we had any problems, they got it fixed. The refs were very nice. Volunteers were wonderful. We had a lot of people. Like, it was just, honestly, it was a great time. If you guys aren't aware of the Gamers Outreach group, it's definitely a great place to be. It was a great tournament. I know that I'm sounding very self-promoting, or, yeah, it sounds like I'm self-promoting them, but I swear to you, I'm not getting paid anything. Honestly, like, I didn't win any money for going there. It was just a great experience. I just think that events like this should be, you know, pointed out more. And if I had known about this in the previous years, I would have gone then too. But I just found out about this event about a month ago. One of my friends saw it on Twitter. So we have that LAN. It was probably the best LAN that I've been to date, aside from MLG events, just because of the scale. But run-wise, it was very well run for a local LAN, and I'd definitely be returning next year. I will go ahead and link the website and their Twitter in the description if you want to check it out. If you have any questions, feel free to ask any of them or me. I can answer any knowledge that I would have gained from being there. But yeah, I honestly cannot wait to go again next year. It's going to be a great experience. So if any of you guys are in the Michigan area, Michigan or you know, Ohio area, be sure to head out there next year. It's going to be a great time. If any of you guys are interested in competitive Call of Duty, they also played StarCraft League. It was a bring your own computer, I believe. BYOC LAN, where you could bring your own systems, set them up, and you could play there all night in their venue. It was at Eastern Michigan College. So, yeah, that's pretty much what I wanted to touch base on there, just to, you know, kind of let you guys know that there are some good LANs out there that aren't really being seen, aside from UMG, because UMG is getting the, you know, the proper support that they should be getting, but there's also some LANs out there that aren't discovered that should be. All of your entry fees are being put straight to charity to, you know, get systems put over to people overseas and children who can't afford them, children in hospitals and stuff like that. I'm not exactly sure of the organizations, but I'm sure that you can look them up if you're interested. I'm positive that, you know, all the entry fees do go to a better place, because, you know, any of the prize money that is being donated, or any of the prize money that is going away to any of the participants, is donated from, you know, all of their sponsors. So I just talked away this whole commentary. I am proud of myself. But yeah, I run the MSMC on my team, the submachine gun. I'm more of a run and gun kind of guy. Run F shit up and get out of there. And, you know, my other teammates, they kind of do cutoffs and stuff. So so that's that. You know, this game is just now winding up here. Got about 50 seconds left. So I hope that you guys enjoyed this. You know, if you guys have any questions, like always, feel free to comment. I love replying to comments. I love getting messages, stuff like that. This last hard point here is intense. So I'm just going to go ahead and let you guys watch this. I hope that you guys enjoyed. You know, check out any links in the description. And hope you guys have a great one. See you later.